This video is kindly being sponsored by Free Trade. If you want to try your hand at investing in the financial markets from as little as £2, you can get a free share worth up to £200 by signing up to Free Trade using the link in the video description below.
Mike.
Check. 1, 2, 3, 4. Jeez. What is going on YouTube? Welcome back to the channel. For those of you that are new here, subscribe. If you want to help me out, smash the like button for the YouTube algorithm, and let's get into what you need to do as a final year student at university. All right, so as a final year student at university, there are two things that you need to be thinking of. The first of which is graduate scheme applications. When are the deadlines? Which ones you want to apply to? How you're going to be strategic about your applications? What industries you want to apply for? What divisions within those industries you want to apply for? And then the second thing you want to think about is a potential application to do a master's degree. So after your undergrad, do you want to go into graduate employment? If you get an offer, great. That's what most people do. If you don't get an offer, do you want to do a master's degree? So then you buy yourself some time and then you can apply for internships in your final year at uni if you say you're going to do a master's degree. This way you buy time, you kind of hedge yourself, you give yourself some insurance option in terms of doing an internship, which you hope to convert into a grad scheme after your master's. So those are the two options. It goes without saying, in around September time, you want to make sure your CV, your cover letter are up to scratch. You want to make sure you have worked on them enough to stand out so that you have a strong application for grad scheme applications, because, you know, spring weeks, internships, those are a lot easier than a grad scheme application. You're going to be competing with people who have done spring weeks, who have done internships. So when you're applying for a grad scheme application, you need to ensure that your application, your cover letter, your CV, all of that are very, very high quality and written to a very high standard. October time, you really want to be meeting employers, going to networking events, whether it's virtual or on campus or at the offices of organizations. Try and go to these insight days, insight evenings, and find out a bit more about the recruiting process. Try and meet people so you can name drop on your cover letter, so on and so forth. But at the same time, you want to keep at the back of your mind, you know, if you're going to be applying for masters, what's the timeline for that application process? When do you need to get your cover letter, your application in, etc., etc.? The general rule is where you do your undergrad, you want to do your master's at a university that is better than your undergrad institution, if there is one. So keep that in mind. That always helps and it shows progression. It just stands out in your applications for internships and grad schemes later on. November time, you want to be doing online psychometric tests for your applications. You want to be preparing for them. You want to be practicing for interviews, assessment centers, psychometric tests, all of that during November. So keep those in mind. Try and get some practice resources. Ask your careers officers at university. I'm sure they'll be able to point you in the right direction. If they're useless, come to the channel, check out what you can, try and learn as much as possible. Before we carry on, it is that time of the video where I need to introduce today's video sponsor, Free Trade. Now, I personally use Free Trade to invest into the financial markets, and I highly recommend you use them if you want to build your experience trading, if you want to, you know, dabble into the financial markets and see what trading is actually like. And the great thing is, you can start from as little as £2. Some of the reasons why I recommend Free Trade is, one, they're super easy to use; two, setup is quick and easy; and three, if you sign up using the link in the video description below, both you and I will get a free share worth anywhere between £3 and £200. So do smash the link below and check them out. If you ask me, it's a no-brainer, but if you're still not convinced, here's a few more reasons why I recommend Free Trade. It's easy to set up, it's quick and easy, there's no hassle. Whenever I have a question, I can ask the team and they usually get back to me pretty quickly. Zero commissions on trades mean I can buy and sell shares without having to worry about an extra cost. Fractional shares allow me to buy shares in companies that are typically quite expensive. And last but not least, they give away free shares worth up to £200. Free shares worth up to £200. So for everyone that signs up to Free Trade using the link in the video description below, both you and I will get a free share worth up to £200. And it goes without saying, always remember, when you invest, your capital is at risk. The value of your portfolio can go down as well as up, and you may get back less than you invest. Remember, for grad schemes, applications will probably end around March, so you want to get your applications in early. A lot of firms offer, you know, places on a rolling basis, so the earlier you get them in, the more likely, or the earlier you can potentially get an offer. So prioritize your applications sooner rather than later. All right, whether you get an offer or interview, keep applying for different types of companies and keep applying for different types of roles. Don't just focus on investment banks. Don't just focus on consulting firms. Spread your eggs across different baskets. I sound like a soundtrack on repeat. I say this so often, but honestly, you want to spread your eggs across different baskets. You want to just get your foot in the door. The most important thing as a graduate who hasn't done a spring week, who hasn't done an internship, or who has but hasn't secured a grad scheme, is to get your foot into the door. Whether that's in the back office of an investment bank, whether that's in consulting, whether that's for a startup, whether that's for a tech company, you want to make sure you get something at the end of your graduation, you know, at the end of your degree. You want to get a grad scheme offer so you can enter the world of work, do a year or two, and then explore your options later on. Because a lot of people do 1 or 2 years and they move, they do something else. Your career is 30, 40 years long. It's a very long time. So your first 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 years plus are just for exploration to find out what you really want to do. Some people, they just focus on applying to one area. They don't get anything. They graduate, they don't have a job lined up. You don't want to be in that position. Trust me, it's a lot more pressure and it's a lot harder to get into the job market afterwards as opposed to breaking in anywhere and then moving around later on. Employers value experience on your CV, and the last thing they want to see is gaps on your CV when you apply to them. So keep that in mind. All right, so March time, most graduate scheme applications are beginning to close for the big investment banks, for the big consulting firms. So at this point, if you're still not getting any, you know, offers or any interviews, you want to start applying to smaller companies whose applications are still open, more niche firms, more boutique type firms. Keep those in mind for March, April, May. And then April, May, you know, it's probably going to be exam season, but at the same time, you're going to be keen on getting your offers. If you're still struggling to secure an offer, you know, explore easier industries, explore something that you might not have considered, talk to your careers officers at university, and just try your best to either decide if you want to do a master's degree or if you want to enter the workforce, enter the job market. Are you willing to completely go for a different industry just to get your foot in the door? If not, what options do you have? If you go for a master's, you can apply for an internship, so that buys you time. If you don't do a master's and want to enter the job market, then you need to kind of, you know, it's your priority to secure an offer somehow. But don't be too picky, as I've mentioned before. If you made it to the end of the video, let me know down below, are you a first, second or third year? What's your current situation? I would love to find out a bit more about, you know, the struggles or the successes that you guys are going through. Make sure you smash the like button for the YouTube algorithm, that way the channel can keep growing. If you're new here, make sure you subscribe and check out some of these videos for more on internships, grad schemes, and all of that good stuff. Until next time, peace.